We continue to follow this breaking news out of Pensacola, Florida, on this deadly shooting at the U.S. Naval Air Station there. A Saudi military member who was training at this facility was the one who shot three people to death. He has also injured at least seven others, including two officers before sheriff's deputies killed the shooter. Florida's governor moments ago saying Saudi Arabia must answer for these killings.
Given that this was a foreign national in the employ of a foreign service, is and there'll be time to do this, but obviously the government of Saudi Arabia needs to make things better for these victims, and I think that they are going to owe a debt here, given that this is one of their individuals.
CNN's Natasha Chin is there in Pensacola for us. CNN's Josh Campbell and Andrew McCabe, CNN contributor and former FBI deputy director, also are with me. But Natasha, you're there, so I just want to start with you. This Saudi national, he was apparently training in aviation. He had a handgun. You're not supposed to have weapons on base. Can you just tell me more about what we know about him?
Sure, Brooke. So we know that he opened fire at a classroom building on base. And like you said, he was not supposed to have that handgun. Now, he did exchange shots with two deputies who then killed him. These two deputies took a shot each, and they are among those injured at this point. And so we had a press conference here right at the base of this bridge just about an hour ago when they were talking about the heroics of people in uniform, both with the Navy and with the local sheriff's office, who really jumped into action. And the sheriff was saying that even those who were injured, even while wounded, still tried to help others. So really, he says a lot of lives were saved today because of that. He also made a point that because this person is a foreign national, there are going to be things about this investigation that cannot be shared as one typically would. So he asked everyone to be patient and to trust the process, but that there may be a lot of questions that we cannot answer. One question I did ask of the officials here was to talk more about the background of this military training of foreign nationals. Perhaps a lot of people did not know that this even happened here on base. So here's what the captain said about that training.
We have a international training syllabus. We have students from several different countries that come here. They learn aviation. They become naval aviators while they're here. It's something that we've been doing for quite a while, and it's with our partner nations. It's important. That cross-pollination, that cross-training that we do with our allies is something that we've done for a long time. I mean, in World War II, we had Royal Air Force folks that were training here. There's always been international students training here because it's a good place to train, and it's a good quality training.
And he said there are a couple of hundred foreign national students like that here on base in Pensacola. And we do also know that the sheriff's office and others have visited victims' families in the hospital. Some of those victims still undergoing surgery, Brooke. Mm-hmm. And so we're just trying to be patient here and waiting for information, which we know mm-hmm. may be limited because of the nature of this case.
Right. Natasha, thank you very much. Andy McCabe, let me turn to you. We know FBI has taken the lead on this investigation. Motive, still too early to tell. The word terrorism has already started being bandied about by some. Isn't it too premature?
It is, Brooke. It's far too premature. And really, for that designation, that qualification, we'd really need to look to the FBI to make it. To make that kind of that statement, the FBI is looking right now in great detail at every aspect of this person's life. So first and foremost, they're looking to see if there's any information in our holdings, in our intelligence holdings, about this person prior to the event. That's probably unlikely here because he's someone who was invited to come train with our military, so there probably was not pre-existing derogatory information about him, or he wouldn't have passed the security checks. They're looking at everyone he came with, everyone he interacted with here in Pensacola. They have gone back, no doubt, to the Saudi government and requested extensive background information about him and his family and his associates. So I'm sure they're looking at his, what we call facilities, his phone numbers, his email accounts that he may have used, social media accounts mm-hmm. that he may have used to figure out who is this person and why did he do what he did. And of course, the overarching concern here is he connected? Could he possibly be connected to other people who directed him in this activity, who supported the activity, or who may be planning it at other locations?
Do you know, we were talking to Barbara Starr last hour, who covers the Pentagon and military, and she was saying that, you know, the fact that he was one of these international students apparently training in aviation, that there is this ongoing, you know, relationship with U.S. military bases and folks from overseas, and how this is a highly valued, you know, relationship and program. And I'm curious what you know about that. Let's just start there. What do you know about that?
Well, it is an incredibly important program to our nation for basically three reasons. Militarily, it gives us the opportunity to train a like-minded cadre of military officers around the country around the world, who we can then rely on in times of conflict and who we know have similar training. Diplomatically, it draws our nations closer together. So those countries like Saudi Arabia that are very important to us internationally, it builds a commonality there. And I should say economically, this is one of
the— Forgive me, Andy, let me interrupt you right now. Let's listen to the president.
The warriors who were killed and wounded in the attack that took place just recently, just this morning, in Pensacola, Florida. The king said that the Saudi people are greatly angered by the barbaric actions of the shooter, and that this person in no way, shape, or form represents the feelings of the Saudi people who love the American people so much. So that was just given to me by the king of Saudi Arabia. And I can tell you it's a horrible thing that took place, and we're getting to the bottom of it. All of the investigators are there now, and they're studying it very closely. And terrible thing. And our condolences go to the families and to everybody involved, including the wounded. We have some badly wounded people also, and we have to extend our condolences to them, and we'll be working with them all very closely. So I just wanted to let you know that was from King Solomon. And today we're here to—
Okay, so condolences not only from the President of the United States, Andy McCabe, but he also was reading some condolences from the Crown Prince, King Salman, over in Saudi Arabia, as this, shooter who is now deceased was Saudi national. You were making a point, though, on how important the international relationship, the training around the world is. Go on.
Yeah, so just to say economically, this is one of the reasons why our allies around the world are anxious to purchase our military hardware, because it comes with the opportunity to then train with our military to learn how to use those things. We're talking about jet fighters and aviation equipment. So it's very important to us on many levels, and it's an incredibly positive program and one that we've gotten a lot of goodwill and relationships out of.
All right. Andy McCabe, thank you for that. Let's go to Josh Campbell now. And Josh, you're there in Hawaii. I mean, this is now the second attack involving a military facility in just a matter of days. There was one at, you know, Pearl Harbor first. Are you talking to service members? How are they feeling? Are they on edge?
Well, if you look at the commonalities here, Brooke, as you mentioned, you have two attacks on the Navy installation within the span of 1 week, which is obviously concerning. There are still questions about whether there's any type of connectivity, perhaps whether the second incident may have been inspired by the first incident. That we have no indication yet that that is the case. This might end up being a coincidence. But nevertheless, that is something that military and law enforcement personnel will be looking at, as far as that commonality and what actually motivated this person there in Florida to conduct this attack. I can tell you, in talking to law enforcement sources, this is now a global investigation. We know that the FBI has assumed federal jurisdiction there in Pensacola. When people think about the FBI, they think about a domestic law enforcement entity, but the FBI also has a very sizable international presence. I just got off the phone with a law enforcement source who says that the FBI's office there in Riyadh, Saudi Arabia, has now engaged with local officials trying to gather as much information as they can about that shooter. And as of this point, they have not landed on that determination that this is terrorism, but that remains part of this investigation. And just, Brooke, as you mentioned, on a personal note, I mean, this is the new normal, to be covering two shootings simultaneously in the United States. This is just where we are.